Hi guys. Welcome back to my channel today, guys. Oh my god, see, let me be honest with you guys, You see, I am so grateful to everybody that supported on that last video. In fact, that was the video with the highest comment ever. Out of all the videos I have been making, I got so many comments actually, and I'm so grateful. Thank you to those that subscribed to my channel through that video. I am so grateful. You are welcome to this channel. In fact, don't worry, this is just the beginning. We're moving forward. Thank you so much. Thank you. So today we're going spiritual, guys. We're going spiritual. And no, you are not about to leave this page, this channel. You're gonna stick to it, because we will be playing together, getting spiritual together, learning things together. So today is time to be spiritual. So guys, I don't know, but as for me, in my own state here, on those states, we are allowed to go to church. And I went to church today, and hi God, I learned some things, and I'm like, let me share it with you people now, Abby. What else? Kill our friend for what are we for? What are friends for? If you cannot share the things that hit you to them. So today in church, I was taught the topic of the sermon was walking through life's hot spot. How to walk through life's hot spot. When I heard through life's hot spot, I was like, hot spot. But it turns out that it wasn't about internet or anything. So the main thing about the topic was brought out from the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 2, that says, when you pass through fire, you will not get burnt, and when you pass through water, the water shall not consume you. I'm not really sure about it, but you get through and read it. I'm just paraphrasing. That is exactly, you can check your Bible for exactly what is written there, and then I can project what is written there later. But it is about passing through fire and not being consumed by the fire. God did not say that we will not pass through fire. God did not say that things will keep going smooth for us. God did not say we will not pass through the waters. But he said that when we pass through the water, it will be with us. And when we pass through the fire, we shall not be consumed. So that is it. Now, the fact that God has promised that we shall not be consumed, I'll be sharing with you five things that I learned. Please, five, just five, Just stick to these things as I share them. Don't go away, Just wait. Welcome guys. So as I was saying, when I say fire, passing through fire, it is not the fire like the house is burning or something. It stands for tough times, difficult times that are so choking, times that you're just like, oh God, can this whole thing just go? It might be financial issues, relationship, whatever it is that looks like you are burning within, like something is disturbing you. That is what I am talking about. Now to the five steps. Number one, how to walk through life's hot spots. How to walk through it. Number one is keep on walking. Obviously, literally, sensibly, when there is fire somewhere now, Abby, you cannot just stay there. You always want to find a way of escape, how to leave that particular place. So when you are going through a particular problem, don't bury yourself in that problem. Do you understand what I'm saying? Don't bury yourself. Try as much as possible to move from that fire, from that problem, from that thing that is disturbing you, from that thing that is making you worry. That is the first thing. Keep on walking. Now, number two, remember that this difficult time will surely pass. Pastor said that we should remember that this difficult time will surely pass. And as a child of God, if you have it at the back of your mind that it will pass, then you have to be patient. Because if you say you are trusting on God, like my last video on trusting God, you remember that I talked about being patient. If you have not seen that video, I'll drop the link in the description box below. You have to see that video, guys, because it is a message from God to you. So as I was saying, you have to remember that this time would surely pass. God makes, like, he has different ways. The fact that this is happening to this person this particular way does not mean it is this particular way it will happen to another person. Now I'm in Ondo State. If I want to go to Lagos from Ondo State, like Pastor said, I can decide to go through Akure to Lagos. I will still get to Lagos. I can decide to go through Ore, I'll get to Lagos. I can decide to go to Ibadan. There are different ways, different routes to wherever it is that you want to go. So just be patient with God as He is working things out in your life. Nothing happens behind God. If you are complaining now, okay, fine. We say that we have bad governance, bad government, and so on. But I want you to know that if God did not want those people to be there, they will not be there. Nothing happens behind God, and He makes everything beautiful in His time. Okay, I'm talking too much on point number two. Now, point number three. Be contented with what you have. Find you, there's a particular problem that you are going through, or whatever it is you are going through, but still, learn to be appreciative of the things that you already have. Learn to be contented with what you have. Use what you have to get what you don't have. Okay, that can go wrong because process you say that, so that's not what I'm talking about. Please, that's not what I'm talking about. But seriously, you have your brain, you have what it is that God has given you. Use the limited resources that you have now, work and build on it, and before you know it, God will enlarge your course. Use, the pastor also said, and I'm gonna quote, make lemonade from your lemon. Make lemonades from your lemon. How, you know, lemon is sour now, very very sour, or lime is very very sour, and that can stand for that tough time, that terrible time in your life. And I don't know how to make lemonade, but I know that they add a little sugar, water, and something. So you have to look for all those things that you have and make a beautiful thing out of it. So making lemonade out of your lemon, that is how you can do it. Be contented with what you have. Be contented with what you have. And I'm saying it again, be contented with what you have. Stop complaining. Stop complaining. Point number four, guys, you have to be true to yourself. You are going through a problem now, Abi. You know that you have a financial problem, but you are earning 100 naira and you are spending 300 naira. How is this possible? Now, you know that you don't have much, but you see a particular dress and, oh my God, I love this dress. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? But you know you don't have the money. Why are you looking at the dress? There are other things that are very important. Hypocrisy would affect your internal energy because you know you are not this, but you want people to think you are this. So it's like you're fighting two things. Like deep down, you know that you are not somebody that can spend too much, but you want to impress, you want to do this, you want to do that, and you are suffering within. Why? You have to be true to yourself if you want a particular situation to pass. You have to spend according to how you earn. You have to spend according to the pocket money you are given. Don't owe debt. Don't do things that will cause trouble for you at the end of the day. That is point number four. Now number five is make yourself happy. Now if you think about it, Abby, you will want to link making yourself happy with spending money, enjoying life, and things like that. But seriously, happiness is from within. Sometimes even people that have money, people that have riches and wealth, are not happy. So happiness is from within, and nobody apart from God and the Holy Spirit, nobody else can make you happy except yourself. You have to make sure that you make yourself happy. You have to be gladder than madder, really. You have to be gladder than madder. You cannot be mad at yourself every time. You keep blaming yourself. Instead of, I learned this from DDK's teaching, that instead of worrying, do not worry, just meditate, think about how would this be better. Or sometimes when you are going through the fire, whatever situation, you have to ask God, what exactly do you want me to learn from this particular thing? God, why is this happening to me? What do you want me to learn from this? What are you trying to teach me? What are you trying to show me? And things like that. So guys, I just hope that somebody, even if it's one person, gained something from everything that I have said. And out of these 5 points, if there is one particular one that really hits you or you really gain something from, just comment it down, write it down in the comment section. I want to see if there's something, it's something I said that minister to you, please write it down. Thank you for listening to this video. You can share with your friends if you like, you can share with your family, and please don't forget to subscribe. I think the subscription is either here or here. I'm sorry, I don't know. I think it's here. No, here. Please just subscribe to this channel. That's the main thing. God bless you. Have a blessed week. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye, guys.